In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Go and set up Visual Studio Code to work with it. Let's open the browser and search for GoLang. Go to this site and click on Download Go. Then choose the correct package for your OS. I'm using macOS, so I will download this one. Once the download is completed, we open the package to install Go. Normally, you just need to click continue until it finishes. Enter your password when being asked. We can check if Go is installed successfully by opening the terminal app and run Go version. There's one important thing that we must do, which is adding the Go bin folder to our path. This folder is located under the Go path, so let's add it to the bash profile file. I'm using Vim, so press I to enter the insert mode. Then type in this export command. Make sure that you have slash bin at the end. Then press escape, colon WQ enter to save the file. Finally, use the source command to load it in the current shell, and we are done. Next, we will install Visual Studio Code. Open your browser and search for VS Code. Open the site and click Download. On macOS, we just need to drag and drop the binary app into the Applications folder. Since we download the app from the internet but not from the App Store, macOS will prevent us from opening it for security reasons. In that case, we need to open System Preference, Security and Privacy, and click Open Anyway. Don't worry, this only needs to be done exactly once when we open the app for the first time. Alright, now Visual Studio Code is successfully opened. The default theme doesn't look very beautiful to me, so I'm going to change it. Open Code menu, Preference, Color Theme. There are multiple themes pre-installed by default. You can use any of them if you like. For me, I will install a new one by clicking on Install Additional Color Themes. I'm going to use the Material Theme Pale Night. I will also install the material icon themes to match with it. Okay, it's done. One thing that I use very often in the terminal is the code command. Basically, we cd to the folder that we want to open with Visual Studio Code and type code dot. Then it should open Visual Studio Code with the current working directory. As you can see, for now it's not working yet, so let's set it up. Open the Visual Studio Code. Type Command Shift P to open the command palette and search for shell command install code command in path. Press Enter. OK. Enter your password, then it's done. Now we can come back to the terminal and type code dot. It works. Now I will show you how to install some plugins for Visual Studio Code to work with Go. Let's create a new project named PC Book and open it with Visual Studio Code. Then create a new main.go file. In the bottom right corner, Visual Studio Code is asking if we want to install the Go extensions or not. Let's go ahead and click Install. Done. Now, as soon as we write package main and define the main function, Visual Studio Code will ask us to install more extensions. Let's install all of them. It will take a while. You can see the progress in the output section at the bottom of the screen. Okay, so now everything is ready. We will write a simple Hello World program. Visual Studio Code will automatically import the FMT package and format the file for us as soon as I press Command S to save it. Let's open the terminal to run it with go run main.go. Yay, it works. Hello World is printed. Now, there is one more thing I want to show you. As you can see on the left, there are two sections. One is PC Book folder that contains all files of our project, and the other is the Open Editors that only shows the current opening files. It might be convenient, but also confusing sometimes. So if you want to disable it, you can open the Code menu, Preference, Settings, then go to Features, Explorer, and look for the Open Editors config and set it to 0. Then it's done. The Open Editors no longer shows up. Alright, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture.